Hi guys, coming up this Kittycast. You're gonna see and hear some wild shoo. We're gonna be talking about Donghua and others in eternal love. 10 miles of peach blossoms. So join me because I really want to hear what you guys think of the characters that I liked and disliked the most. Join me. Hey guys, this is Snowfoo the Kitty, and this is my second ever Snowfoo the Kitty cast. And you notice I'm not calling it a podcast, and I'm not calling it a vlogcast. I'm literally calling it a Snowfoo the Kitty cast because I'm Snowfoo the Kitty, and it's my podcast, so thus I combined it. Anyway, the thing I want to talk about today, rewatching Donghua, Dijun, and Eternal Love, 10 Miles of Peach Blossoms. Now, of course, I rewatched all of the characters, right? I mean, so it's not like I was just looking and waiting for Vingo Gao as Donghua Dijun to walk onto the screen. I wasn't. But also, let me just mention that in this one, you're probably going to be seeing background images or footage of Eternal Love, 10 Miles of Peach Blossoms with Donghua, starring Vingo Gao, of course, as Donghua. And the reason for that is, the reason I started watching it is it goes off Netflix, and I know I have it on Youku and some other things, but it goes off Netflix November 15th. So me and my homes, we decided to get together and watch it. Oh my God, guys, I had forgotten how badass Donghua was, right? He just goes down for a love trial with Feng Shui and comes back up and all of this. But then, remember the episodes where Chin Chin gets her memory back, her lost memories, where she was Susu. And when that happened, and she went to heaven, and she's like, oh, I'm gonna pop off on Sujin, whatever, concubine, hoe, whatever. I did not like her character. I mean, she's a great actress because she was just a hideous, hideous woman. Hideous character. So as an actress, I'm sure she was really great. I mean, she's really talented. So when Chin Chin goes and she gets her eyes back, she's like, I've been drinking a lot, you know. My hands may be shaking when I dig them out of your head or whatever it was, right, that she says. And then that witch goes, oh, take me to Heaven Lord. And can I just say, I cannot stand Heaven Lord. He's just a piece of S. I'm serious. He's useless. Nothing. The entire series. He did nothing but cause trouble and make everyone miserable. Meanwhile, he has his 50 million concubines, right? And takes his own granddaughter, raised as his granddaughter, as his consort, right? And even though he didn't touch her, whatever. Oh, and while I'm at it, what is up with Sujin? It's like, I've been with Yuwa since before he was born. I was there when he was born, so I want to F him? Really? So anyway, back to the point. I know, it's Imperial China. I know, I mean, it's not Imperial. I can't believe I said it's Imperial China. Oh my gosh, no, China, I love you, love you, love you, love you. Oh gosh. So anyway, before I get in trouble, back to my point, which is, you know, she was, hold on guys, I'll be right back, hold on. Okay, I literally paused because I saw something. I thought it was a spider, and it wasn't, it was a cricket, a lucky cricket. I saw one the night before I found my stray kitty. I got my stray kitty. I found my stray kitty. But I'm all off point. And now I don't remember where I was. Where was I? Talking about how she wanted to have her brother, and then she goes to Heaven Lord, and Heaven Lord's such a douchebag. And so then, she's like, oh, you've got to believe me, you got to believe me. And in walks Donghua Dijun, right, with Fangzhi. And he's like, hey, yo, Heaven Lord, guess what? When this shit went down, Sujin was your consort, so you need to step back and let me handle it, right? And no one can tell me, and I think that's when I fell in love with him completely and utterly, Donghua Dijun, my freaking emperor forever. So, I mean, he steps up, and then he's like, he's got them all, you know, kowtowing to him because, hey, nobody messes with him, right? And he knew exactly what he was doing, and I'm quite sure he knew that Yiwa was about to wake up in the, or die, in the mortal realm. I don't really do much. I've been hanging around a different area. How about starting 70,000 years ago and telling me your whole story? Yeah, I need about 30 minutes, because that's how long it'll take Yiwa to wake up back here, you know, and die in the mortal realm. So, and it was so incredible because it's like, hey, yo, can you tell me what the punishment is for such and such crime? And they'd say it, and he turns into Siming, and he like gestures, and he's like, hey, note that, you know what, write that down, because I need to remember that. It was fantastic, guys. It was literally fantastic. I haven't finished it yet. I'm at the part where, you know, Li Jing. Li Jing. Oh, God, you guys. Like, seriously, I can't even. He tries to do something so good. So good. And you know why he's trying to do it? Because he knew Shen Shen, or Yan as he would call her, he knew that she was going to seal his father back in again and possibly get killed. And he's like, I've got to do something. I've got to do one decent thing with my life. And Li Jing's character is just... I mean, he brought everything on himself, right? But, oh, God, I think it's his eyeliner. It's just so sexy. I really want to know what you guys think. Because, and you know, what's so interesting, the other thing, going back to Donghua Dijun, his character, they put him in those really muted, like almost plum color, right? That deep, deep color. I'm wondering why. Was it to keep him kind of muted in this, in the background? Because there's no way you can keep Donghua Dijun muted in any background. I don't care what he has on. It doesn't matter. He's going to stand out. And he's the lead in Book of Dream, and that's why they put him in brighter. Or if it was just a random costume color change choice for him. I don't know, but... yeah, he was amazing. Don't you guys think he was just so amazing? This is a shorter Kittycast than last time, but hey, I'm going to sign off. I'm going to go. So I will see you guys later. I love you.